appears because...
No. Six senators voted in favor, the three social partner senators and the three senators from the opposition, and all six senators for the government voted against. In this matter, the Constitution is clear. The President does not have a casting vote when it comes to any matter relating to Section 61AD, which is exactly what we were dealing with today.
So then, but the President didn't recognize that, although you put that to him, so it will be recorded that your motion was defeated, not that it was deadlocked.
It had better be recorded that it was deadlocked, because if the Hansard reflects that there are seven votes, I am prepared to go to court to clear the Hansard, because the President does not have a vote when it comes to matters dealing with Section 61AD of the Constitution.
Could you explain 61AD to me?
61AD is precisely the section here to investigate wrongdoing and to investigate those allegations. That touches and concerns specifically the Senate's power to investigate wrongdoing and corruption. And when it comes to that, the President, who is not a senator, and this one isn't, does not have a vote. And the Constitution trumps whatever it is anybody thinks they're going to find in the standing orders or otherwise. It's the supreme law of the land.
Okay, so then, but still, your motion, though valiant, did not succeed.
Unfortunately, Jules, that is so. And I will tell you, I am massively disappointed that the Minister of Immigration should have voted no in this, after all his brave words about his not fearing the light and anybody could come. Clearly anybody could come except the Senate, except his own colleagues with whom he sits every Senate meeting. Those are the people he doesn't want investigating. Those are the people he doesn't want to hold a public inquiry. And the public has every right to ask the Minister of Immigration, why did he vote no? He was invited by Senator Montejo to, in fact, recuse himself, because it is his ministry that we're dealing with. And you saw that he took the privilege of being a minister to make a public statement, today, which nobody could answer, nobody could respond to give all kinds of information for the first time to the media, to the Belizean public, that nobody had heard before. All this narrative, all of this thing about not being afraid, all the red herring about the Auditor General and the Auditor General's powers, he still could not answer the plain fact that the Senate is not the cart of the Auditor General's horse. And that is a fact.